listen to Came From the Radio, and you know this is Dr. Feldy. I am blessed and favored to be here with Jamie McAfee, author and screenwriter of The Seed, and Alexis Weil. Welcome.
Hi, thank you for having me.
So we're going to go right into now. I'm going to go into The Seed before we go to Alexis Weil. I'll read a little description that I took from the internet. Women cannot write the future, but women can put a plan in motion to change it. Emerson Golden is a high-powered lawyer practicing for the woman in her state. After a significant loss, a mysterious entity places a technological opportunity in front of her she can't resist. She joins a team of women to correct everything wrong with the world. New power comes into play when the mission set forth is clear. Plant the seed and it will grow. Now, you mentioned mysterious entity. Is this pure fantasy, or do you believe in mysterious entities, gods, maybe assisting us in real life?
I believe we do have some higher powers around us. And I mean, I think everybody knows now there are some probably dark money figures and a little bit of other, maybe not even just a spirit, but humans that are kind of pulling strings behind the scenes. So, yeah, with The Seed, it's kind of like my answer to Handmaid's Tale, I would say.
Now, when you say dark money figures, you mean like human dark money figures, or there are spirits that mess with money?
No, these are, well, The Seed is kind of a branch between the human world and technology. So it's using technology to get ahead, but you have to have money behind the technology to get forward and get things done that you need done. So maybe there are higher powers in human form that are trying to change things in the world to favor themselves. So they use
that doesn't sound like reality at all.
Very interesting. A little bit of something of things that are happening in current life. I always say it. They might use it as a documentary form, maybe.
Interesting. We'll have to follow up on this one, see where the future goes. Now, the description of The Seed, my last question of The Seed so far, it also states plant the seed and it will grow. Now, could you please share some seeds that you've planted that have grown into fruition?
Ooh, I would say Alexis Weil is a plant, is a seed that is growing. So that is a plant that I kind of left in a bag, kind of waiting for me to be able to plant and let it go. And last year, I just decided to go ahead and get it done. And now it is blossoming into the character that I want it to be, into the story that I want it to. It's just growing. And as far as The Seed is concerned, that is also a plant that I am still working on growing. So
now, Alexis Weil is probably going to have a sequel, right? There's probably going to be a few variants and maybe a second, a third, because it kind of leaves off as a cliffhanger. Now, for our listeners, could you just tell us what Alexis Weil is for people who haven't read your book?
Yes. So Alexis Weil is a dystopian action adventure. Is female-led. Alexis, she's a young woman that has been tossed into this kind of hell realm by the evil Rhapsodist, along with humans from Earth. He kind of took over the entire planet, except for a small area, which we'll learn a bit more in the future about. But she basically is taking over his world and trying to help the survivors. So she protects them. They kind of learn how things work. There is a technology aspect to it as well. So they're using things that they've learned in the human world to survive this new world. So they build cool things. She has an Infinity X team, which is a group of people that survived as well, but they all have their own skills and they work with her to kind of combat all of the different things that are happening. So they have quite interesting evil entities that they battle with, from Rhapsodist himself, who can take on different forms, so you never really know who he is. That, and then there's monsters made of steel, so they are part human, part steel. It's very scary, very eerie, demons and all.
Now, the steel part, that had me, I don't know. I see, I'm not big in the comic book world. I'm big in the medical field. And of course, they're putting all steel implantations and this and that. But where did you get the idea to make body parts made of steel and metal? Where did this come from? The Tin Man?
Right. It's kind of just a scary thing where it's like they have protective armor around their own bodies. So picture like a large monster that you can't you need different tools in order to conquer it. So, like, but they are kind of living. So, yeah.
I liked at the end, well, I guess spoiler alert, sorry. She gets in a little bit of a battle with this guy and he looks real scary. He has this big long tongue and his blood. I love that tongue effect. It's just really fun. You see that a lot in comic books with this long tongue, the bad guy. Well, comic books, the bad guy has a big, long, scary tongue. What's up with that?
I don't know. Maybe it's like I feel like a serpent side. That, you know, I had my ideals on what I wanted the vision to be. And my illustrator, Mark Renee, he kind of took it to the next level. He's like, ooh, how scary do we want to make this guy?
You know, he reminds me of like those 80s bad guys where it'd be like a whack guy. Maybe he's Norwegian or Nordic and he's skiing on a mountain. And maybe he lives in a house that kind of looks like my neighbor's. It looks very modern. Maybe like the dad and Heather, something like that, that type of family. Anyway, I'm just rambling here. Let's get to my question list. Okay, so Alexis Wilde. This is from your online description. The battle to save what is left of humanity falls in the hands of Alexis Wilde. The stakes are rising, and it falls to Alexis and the Infinity X team to navigate and stop the unending madness this new twisted world bleeds. It kind of reminds me of how President Bukele saved El Salvador, by the way. El Salvador is now supposedly safer than Canada, the United States, even Uruguay, and he saved them from a literal war with MS-13. There was over 70,000 MS-13. Now, it's just a little thing on my mind. Now, how does Alexis stop the madness like Bukele saved El Salvador? How does she do it?
She has not figured that out yet. So they are just kind of just battling things and taking on monsters as they appear. They're trying to figure out ways to get out, how we can protect these people, what we can do. But yeah, she used her weapons. She's just very strong right now, but we have some things coming up.
All right, so she's trying to figure it out. Now, is there any chance that the world's going to become like El Salvador, the crime capital of the world? And maybe we're going to need Alexis? Are things going to get really bad before they get good?
I mean, it's a hellscape, so it's pretty bad already. It's very bad. We definitely need her, and we'll need her in the future.
But you know what? If there's always so bad, it could be because she did get a good night's sleep. She looked like she's beautiful and well-rested. And for me, when things are a hellscape, which, you know, my 2023 was a hellscape in a lot of ways, I was not sleeping through the night. So that Alexis girl, she's taking Ambien. What's her trick to sleep at night? What's going on?
They kind of learned to survive in this world, but she didn't really have a sound sleep. She was reliving the nightmares of her past. So
scratch that.
Yes.
All right. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit more about Alexis. My last question. What made you create Alexis the way you did? What drove your choices about her looks, her actions?
Well, there's not a lot of characters that kind of look like me. I wanted her to be brown. I wanted her to be tough and kind of showcase that she can have. She has a bit of a poetic side, so she is a little poetic, but also very strong. She speaks her mind, and she also sometimes she needs a little alone time, but she also wants to protect the one she loves. So she has multivariants of being a woman, I would say.
Well, you're very beautiful. I could see some. I could see you being related for sure.
Thank you.
Definitely. Now, all right. Getting back to the spiritual exit, I believe, and I actually did have a psychic reading from Dorothy Kadosh that has predicted things since 2010 with all different people I know. So I guess I'm in that realm today. And I haven't really been involved at all. And now I believe many writers, comedians, songwriters actually get their information, so does she, from another realm. Like she told me, you're smart, but you're not that smart. You're very connected and you're channeling. So maybe a lot of our ideas are not our ideas. You ever get information or predictions or any type of idea and just wonder how you knew such things?
I do, honestly, from the Alexis Wilde story, I wrote it 13 years ago. So this is taking it way back. And some of the things kind of mirror things that are happening today, even in the world, with because we do have a lot of dark figures in power positions that are trying to take over. So we have a lot of war and a lot of different things that are happening. And so she is that person. It's kind of weird that there's a little biblical aspect to some of the characters and names and everything. And it's almost like I've predicted that. But with the second book, you mentioned that. I do have the Indiegogo coming up on June 11th. So people can go ahead and help back the project so we can get the second book going. That story is there.
And at the end of this interview, we'll have you list all your socials. We're going to make sure so that you can donate to this Indiegogo. Now, you're right. And I actually wasn't bored at all reading this comic. You know, a lot of times people send me things. I go, oh, no, what kind of a snooze buster is this going to be? But I was quite riveted. And I even had to tell someone to shut nicely so I could focus because I was really enjoying your story. So, it, you know, whether you're into comics or not, you know, medical field, construction, I like it a lot. I'm a big fan. I thought it was quite interesting. Now, you've gifted the world with your writing. What has writing gifted you?
Writing has gifted me the opportunity to express myself in ways that I might not be able to do verbally, whether it's a feeling that you have, whether it's a happiness you want to be able to explain how you're feeling. A pen to paper, I can always put it out there and let people know how I feel. So that is the gift to me, I feel.
Which leads us to my next question. If you couldn't write, what other tools or mediums, videos, open mics, movies, talk shows would you use to express yourself?
Ooh, if I couldn't write, I'd probably have to sing somehow.
I can see that. Maybe you could do that anyway.
Yeah, for sure. I do like writing lyrics, so might need to do that.
Maybe you could have a singing component where instead of like an audio book, it's a singing book, but not a musical. I can't stand those. No offense.
Right.
I don't like musicals. Mean Girls was on TV. I was like, oh, Mean Girls too. And then I saw they started singing. I said, click, click, goodbye. Bobby. See you later. Yeah. It's nothing like someone going into song too many times to make me run out that door. All right. Now, personal question. What messages would you like to share with the world?
Maybe just, you know, believe your own eyes. I would say when you see something, believe what you're seeing, believe the words that you're listening to, always believe things. Cause I feel a lot of people are just not, taking in the reality of what they're seeing in life right now. They kind of just, you know, are listening to different words from people that maybe are not the truths, or maybe seeing things that are not truth. But in real life, if you're out in the world and you see something, you know what's happened. If you know it's maybe wrong, if it's not right, you should probably believe it.
Believe your own eyes. Right. Okay. Now, back to spirituality. There's a portal in your comic book. You think portals exist? I've been told that there are multiple portals in this house, this home right here. And I've been told my mirrors are portals and I need to like close them off or do something to close them off. Okay. I don't know. What are your thoughts on all that?
There might be. I don't check anything off. There could be a portal. One in Alexis world. So
very cool. I really like this Alexis comic book. Good job. Yeah, good job. And I'm very curious to see. I was at a cliffhanger and I'm like scrolling to the bottom because I read it digitally. So we're scrolling here. And I'm like, wait, where's this other girl? Because there's another girl who shows up. And I'm like, who's this? Do we trust her? And I don't know. I don't know about this one. And she's very pretty and green-eyed. And I don't know. It's maybe too pretty to be sweet. Although, according to Dorothy, a lot of people have beauty because they're inside beauty. That's where your beauty comes from, according to one. Now, another personal question. What sacrifices have you made to achieve your successes and produce your writing? Any successes or no successes? I mean, no sacrifices, I mean.
For me, I feel like the most I sacrifice is probably my time. Mm-hmm. So I give all of my free time to my writing projects, whatever I'm trying to get done. I probably wish I could use that time to travel more or you know, use my funds to do any of that. But instead, I want to make sure I get the cool stories to everyone. And I have to make the dream come true. So that's why I work so hard.
Okay, traveling. I hate traveling. So to me, you're not missing out on anything. But you know what? A lot of people love it. So, hey, I guess I feel bad that you're not getting your traveling in. Who knows? I don't remember those remote controls in the hotel are actually more dirty than a toilet seat. So you're not missing out on that.
That's true.
I have to ask about AI in this swiftly changing world. Do you utilize AI?
I'd be lying if I said I didn't look at some things. It's probably more of the, because I'm not a fan of AI's like stealing things from people. So I would never want to use any of that. But I have used it. I'm probably like, ideas for things. What would you use this for that? Or how would you explain this? And then you get an idea. I'd probably use that more for like the resume side of life. You know, the regular work documents.
What can I use this for? You know, a lot of my male patients come in and they say, what can I use my wife for? She's useless. What can I use her for? Maybe they could turn to the AI. I don't know.
That's what it's for, you know?
Yeah, to help them figure out how to use your wives and use your husbands. Because you're like, I don't have any use for this thing anymore. What do I do? Just sell it at a garage sale?
Right.
Can't do that, you know, until death do us part. So they say, I'm just their doctor. So we're going to the last questions. Now, what do you do to increase flow and eliminate writer's block? Which I feel like you don't get writer's block, but maybe I'm wrong.
So I listen to music pretty much, or I'll watch a new show where I'm trying to along the lines of something maybe I'm writing to inspire me a bit, but. No, I listen to a lot of like the pop music or old hip hop, something to what? Get you energized.
50 Cent. Mind. I like 50 Cent. 50 Cent.
We do. I do like 50 Cent. I mean, you like the throwbacks, probably 50 Cent. And then I like some of the pop stuff as well. Like, give me a Dua Lipa song, you know?
Okay. All right. Can't blow. Before I was a doctor, I was in Camp Low videos. That was pretty cool. All right. Now, last question of the day. When your energy, you're just so bright and vibrant, it's hard for me to picture with low energy, but I think we all go there sometimes. When your energy is too low for your liking, what do you do to perk yourself up?
You want to do something fun. Maybe I'll run out to Disney. I am in Orlando. So, like, you're going to perk yourself up. You go on a Disney ride just go to the beach also. Taking the oceans in.
Right. Definitely. All right. Great. Now, that leads us to the end of our interview. You made it all the way through. You succeeded. Could you tell our listeners where to find you, your websites?
Ooh. So they can go to alexiswile.com. So it's Alexis and then Wile is W-Y-L-E. .com and then or jamiemcafee.com. And McAfee is like the virus scanner, so just come and find me.
you know what's very interesting, on the day he died, I think he died the day before, my computer, this computer right here, I started getting all these McAfee pop-ups.
That's
super weird. And today I woke up with George magazine in my head. I opened my email, one of my emails was George. Very weird. It's been a weird day. And my final thought to you, anything that you'd like to share with the world, final thought?
Just come on and check out the Indiegogo. You can also go on Instagram. I'm at AW Comic if you want quicker info and on the move. But just check out the Indiegogo. It starts January 11th. So check out the book. You can get the second book, be a part of it. There is
January 11th.
Yeah. Oh, not January. Did I say January?
Yes.
Maybe I am
June,
a time
traveler. Right? I was like, June. I heard June.
It's June 11th.
Perfect. 2024. All right. We'll put that on the video. All right. And I will just say, I find Alexis Wall more interesting than Wonder Woman. I'll just leave it at that. I don't know. I think she's more interesting. I don't really, no offense to Wonder Woman. I'm just not feeling any attraction to and but Alexis Wall, I'm like, what is this girl doing? I want to know. So yeah, you got me interested. Well, Jamie, thank you so much, Miss McAfee. I wish you continued success, and please report back on hopefully more success in the next coming year.
Yes, thank you so much.
And now back to the studio. Thank you, Mark.